So, next reaction we will be doing is Martial Arts History by Amy Johnson. And it's from episode 2, Tai Chi. Now, I know I didn't react to this for a long while, so let's get to it in 3, 2, 1.
Hey everyone, it's Amy Johnston, and welcome back to another episode of Martial Arts History. So in this series, I go in depth into the history of several different martial arts styles. The martial art for today is Tai Chi. Before we get started, I just want to say that I don't know everything. I've been doing martial arts for a very long time, but that does not make me a master in any particular art. So this is just things that I have learned and things that I want to share with you that I think are cool. So with that said, I don't know everything, so if I miss something that you want to add, please do leave your comments down below, and we can just create this huge martial arts nerd fest in the comment sections and learn from one another. So let's get started on today's episode of Tai Chi. Tai Chi means grand ultimate fist, and it's actually a form of moving Qigong. Qigong is cultivating energy. Tai Chi is a form of martial arts whose principles rely on integrating the functioning of the mind and the body as one. It's a graceful and gentle exercise which can be used to better one's lifestyle and defensive skills. In Tai Chi and Eastern philosophy, it's important to be in harmony with oneself and the universe. So there are several styles of Tai Chi, but they all trace back to the Chen village. The styles are Yang, Wu, Wu Hao, Chen, and Sun. While Tai Chi is known for its slow movement, Yang, Wu, and Chen tend to carry a faster pace, which is why I think that they are a little bit more popular. Tai Chi is a renowned form of martial arts, which originated around 1670 in China. It was based on Qigong and other techniques. This form of martial arts gained attention as it could be served as a form of fighting as well as exercise. Its origins can be accredited to Zhang Sanfeng, who was a Taoist monk. Tai Chi can be held as a practice that pushes the boundaries of how one thinks and perceives. It challenges the hierarchy and rituals meant for us to follow. Tai Chi has spread all over the world and has been embraced as a form of exercise for spiritual enhancement. In the early 20th century, Yang Chenfu began teaching Tai Chi in the United States. Since then, Tai Chi has gained a lot of popularity for its easy and less stressful methods and became part of a regime for elderly people to exercise. It's even been adopted by hospitals and nurseries, which I think is awesome. Training for Tai Chi or Tai Chi Chuan requires understanding of the five elements that it constitutes. Tao Lu is a solo open hand or weapon form. Ni Gong and Qigong are meditation, so breathing and awareness. Tui Xiao are response drills, and San Shou are self-defense movements. A combination of all these elements is the essence of Tai Chi. Tai Chi's philosophy is of non-violence. It teaches its students that meeting violence with violence is only catastrophic and will most likely result in collateral damage, which is something I think that we can all learn from. The art lies in using slow motions and gentleness as an alternative to the opponent's aggression until they tire out and we can redirect their attack safely. The commonly heard yin yang or vice versa is the primary goal of teaching Tai Chi, to meet one force with its complete opposite. Lao Tzu provided the gist for Tai Chi when he wrote, "The soft and the pliable will defeat the hard and strong." Tai Chi teaches that enhancing one's inner qi will improve health and prolong life. Enhancing qi requires learning specific breathing techniques and movements. To gain access to Tai Chi's health benefits doesn't necessarily require an in-depth research into Chinese philosophy. Rather, a person should just understand the concept of Tai Chi to better his or her approach to this form of martial arts. Tai Chi is based on two components. One is qi, which is thought to be a force of energy that flows through your body. You want to unlock your inner qi. The second component is yin and yang. As previously stated, these are opposite elements that exist in our universe and that need to be in balance for optimum results in life. So there are five elements that form the life and health cycle. They're all related to different organs, different emotions, colors. They are water, wood, fire, earth, and metal. After the Chinese Civil War, the Chinese government wanted to promote Tai Chi and incorporate it into the Wushu competitions. The different forms of Tai Chi were amalgamated into one form known as the competition form. In the 1950s, another form was created, which was the 97 movements combined. These modern takes on Tai Chi Chuan have become an important part of international competitions. Tai Chi, due to its slow and deliberate motions, has been incorporated as a relaxing and meditative exercise, which is why it's widely practiced by many celebrities in Hollywood as well. The most prominent Tai Chi scene in film that comes to mind for me is Roadhouse, when Patrick Swayze is doing Tai Chi on the beach. It's a very memorable scene. He's got his shirt off. It's a great scene. And then there's Tai Chi Master, Man of Tai Chi Zero, Tai Chi Hero. Also, I'm gonna say that I think the philosophy of Tai Chi was incorporated into The Matrix. I actually think that's in several movies. Like the basic idea of being in harmony with everything around you and yourself and harnessing your inner energy or chi. There are so many books that have been written about Tai Chi, the most popular book being Chen Su's 13 Treatises on Tai Chi Chuan. Tai Chi has proven to have numerous medical benefits on aging and health. It's an ancient practice of integrating mind and body movements. As previously mentioned, Tai Chi gained popularity due to its potential of releasing stress, and its benefits don't stop there. It also improves the body's immune system, eases chronic muscle pain, and improves a person's efficiency when exercising. Tai Chi infuses the spiritual and physical aspects of life with perfect harmony, and that is why it is rightfully a renowned form of martial arts. So I haven't studied too much Tai Chi or Qigong, but it's something that I really want to focus on, because I know the times that I have done Qigong with my mom, who teaches Tai Chi and Qigong, I feel so centered and aware after class, and maybe I'm crazy, but the colors seem brighter. Like, my body really gets into a relaxed state by connecting certain breathing techniques with movements, along with visualization. Tai Chi, Qigong, breathing techniques, or any form of meditation is so powerful and I think so important. So actually creating this episode on Tai Chi is getting me really inspired to go do some Tai Chi right now, actually. Maybe I will after I film this video. We don't always breathe perfectly, and I know that sounds weird because obviously we have to breathe to live, but because we're not always paying attention to our breath, we might be holding our breath a lot of times, and that can cause stress in the body, which causes tension, which can eventually cause injury. So it is so important to breathe properly, get that time to relax, whatever it is for you, actually. It might not be Tai Chi, Qigong, meditation. It's so important to get your body into that relaxed state as much as you possibly can. Okay, well, I'm absolutely inspired to go do some Tai Chi now, so I'm gonna get out of here. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Please make sure to tune in to next week's episode. Remember, like I said, if you wanted to add anything that I missed, please leave your comments down below, and we can start up that nice martial arts nerd fest that I spoke about earlier, and I just can't wait to hear from you. Please do subscribe if you haven't already, and if you have, go ahead and hit that notification bell. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Thank you. All right, I think that's it for martial arts history. So I think I'm going to do the next episodes from episode 3. And I'll see you tomorrow. Well, I'm still keep going, but I'll see you in the next video. Bye.